Welcome to episode 2 of the Introduction to Adobe Premiere Rush for iPad. My name is Jess, and in this tutorial, we are going to be using the features available in the free version of this app. In this video, we are going to cover the basics of the Adobe Premiere Rush timeline, including how to zoom in and out, move, rearrange, trim, split, and delete clips, and what the different tracks are. Let's get started. In our last episode, we had just finished adding media clips to our timeline. The timeline is the horizontal bar at the bottom of your screen where all of your media is displayed. The blue line, also known as the playhead, indicates the exact moment you are at in your video and coincides with what is currently displayed on the playback screen above. Just above the timeline, you will see time markers showing you the timing of where you are in your video. Before we move on, I want to point out the two horizontal lines on the bottom right side of the video playback screen. If you tap and hold this button, you can scroll your finger up and down on the screen to resize the video and the timeline. This can be helpful when you want a clearer view of what you are editing on your timeline, or if you want to enlarge the video to watch it more clearly. To scroll through the clips on your timeline, simply swipe back and forth with one finger over top of or just below your clips. You can also use two fingers to pinch and zoom in and out. To select a clip on your timeline, simply tap it once. You will know which clip is currently selected as it will have an orange border. If you want to select more than one clip, you can tap the cursor button in the bottom left corner of your screen. You can then select and deselect multiple clips on your timeline. This can be useful when applying an edit that you want uniform across all of your clips. When you are done with your selection, simply tap the cursor button again. This will deselect all clips except for the one the blue playhead is currently on top of. To move a clip, tap and hold it with your finger and then slide your finger in the direction you would like the clip to go. You will see an orange outline highlight spaces you can move your clip to. To trim a clip, find the point where you would like your clip to end and have the blue marker over top of it. Then press and hold the center of the thick orange handles on the clip and scroll it towards the blue marker until it snaps in place. You can also just click and hold that orange handle and slowly scroll until you get to a spot you'd like to trim to. Splitting clips is useful when you want to use different parts of the same clip throughout your video. It can also be useful as another way to trim clips without using the scrolling method mentioned previously. To split a clip, move the playhead over the clip where you want to split it. Now, you can either tap the scissors icon on the left-hand toolbar, or you can tap the clip itself and an orange toolbar will pop up with the same scissors icon. You can now move the split clips where you would like them in your timeline, or you can delete any parts you do not want to use. To delete a clip, first tap on it so it has the orange highlight, and then either tap the trash can icon in the left side toolbar, or tap the clip again for that orange pop-up toolbar for the same button. When we have the pop-up toolbar open, you can see there's a third button available, Duplicate. This is useful if you want to reuse the same clip elsewhere in your video, or it can also be helpful to duplicate a clip before editing it so you can compare edits. Again, this can be selected in the pop-up or on the left side toolbar. They both work the same way, it just comes down to your personal preference. The final topic we will touch on in this episode are the tracks. The tracks are the different parts of the timeline that you can add video, audio, graphics, and titles to. To view all of the tracks, you can tap the Tracks button in the left side toolbar. In Premiere Rush, you can have a maximum of 7 tracks in the timeline, 4 video tracks, and 3 audio-only tracks. Video tracks support video with or without audio, images, and graphics. Audio-only tracks support audio-only clips, such as music and voiceover recordings. The main track we have used so far is the video or V1 track. When you import video footage or still images, they are all arranged on this V1 track by default. If you import audio files or add titles, those clips are placed in separate tracks in the timeline. We will dive deeper into these other tracks in future episodes when we start to add titles, graphics, and audio. So that's it for this tutorial on the basics of the timeline and tracks in Adobe Premiere Rush for iPad. In the next episode, we will cover adding and customizing titles and graphics and how to save your customizations as presets to easily reuse again. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.